What is up, you guys?
It's your boy Seth B.
And right now,
we're talking about
the life of skateboarding in Nevada,
and how it's not really planned, and it could be developed in a positive way and a negative way. You know, it just depends on the group of people that make the era good. You know, because of the fact that it could be a good skate boom in Nevada, or it could be a negative one. And the reason it could be a boom is because California is moving to Nevada, and you know, there's a lot of skateboard action in there, you know? And then I want to do a hotel, you know, for skateboarding, you know? Which is really great, you know? It could be whatever it is. It could be a good thing, it could be a bad thing. But it's like, it depends on the people willing to make an era lock, you know? And like, you know, magazines, like the brands and stuff like that. Because I mean, if you look at it, the eras that were good, they were planned. You know, the brands are planned, the boards are planned, everything was planned. So the skate boom in Nevada could be really good, you know, as far as like the image of the skater, the identity of the life, you know, the contests, the brands, you know, things like that. You know, it's because like every era had their thing. Like the early guys had the flatland skating, then they had the Skatopia stuff, then they had the street skating, and then they had the, like, you know, the park skating, you know. But the life of the skating has changed, you know. So that's a really good opportunity right now in skateboarding to create and develop the identity in Nevada, the Nevada skate, you know, as far as contests and things like that, you know, like to be on the map, on the skate map, you know, because I mean, when it comes to skating in Nevada and Los Angeles, I mean, in Las Vegas, there's not that much stuff. Like if you were to go to Hollywood, or you were to go to Long Beach, or you were to go to Cerritos and different places to skate, you know, it's not like that here. So like, there's a gap to have really good skating, but it just depends on like the brands and the people in front of it, you know, like magazines and media and things like that. I mean, the it's out here. There's space, there's things, you know, it's just taking the dip, you know, going broke for skateboarding, you know, to be established in the city. But I think it's really about the comps, man. There's a possibility like for comps and things like that, but it's just the identity of the skateboarding, you know. It's crazy. But right off the bat, I have like a bunch of ideas for skate competitions, like the Hot Box Challenge brought to you by, you know, some cannabis dispensary in town, you know. And what you do is we set up these fun boxes and call them hot boxes, you know, and they can skate, you know, because the Hot Box Challenge of Nevada. But, you know, or the high jump or just random shit like that. But so that's the skateboarding part. The other thing is working on this warehouse dome thing. You know, like, that place is awesome. Like, that's the one I want to buy. You know, that's what I want to do. Like, at the same time, you know, how it's open space, during the week have crate racing, you know, with the little, like, beer crates and shit to help promote local bars and, you know, and help promote local alcohol or imported alcohol, you know, just to support alcohol in a different way besides the alcoholism, you know, because that'll be cool to have something to do on a Tuesday or a Thursday, you know what I mean? And like see the people race little beer crate cars. So that was what I was thinking. It's just, I'm just thinking about a bunch of stuff I'd want to do, you know, with my time. Cause you know, it sucks when you didn't plan your time and then you don't have nothing to do, it puts you in a position to be hit by something you don't want to do, you know? So that's what I was thinking, like a Tuesday or Thursday or when I have free time. Cause honestly, I was planning on just like Friday, Saturday, having the dance music stuff and just drive trucks during the week, you know? And that's how I was gonna pay for it. But, you know, I was gonna put in like a good 10 years of driving the truck to be able to put in a really good nightclub, you know? So that's what that was. So it could be the way I want to, so it wouldn't be stressful. So it's like the startup capital and all that stuff, you know, just to do it the correct way, you know? And then my mom's an accountant, you know, she went to school to be an accountant. So we got an accountant in the house, you know? It's just crazy, man, getting hit by so many different things, you know? Everybody wants to be local, global space, you know? And it's like, they don't want to do the work, you know? They just want to hit. It's just a mix of like a bunch of stuff, you know? It's like the legend of the body snatchers and stuff. But the body doesn't belong to me, you know? It does, like, cause I'm like doing the dip for them. But at the same time, it's like my sister's, and like, he's got an older guy, you know? It's weird, cause we never went to the bar. He doesn't drink, you know?
He always just went to the Moose Man's house, and he's older horse. That's what solved everything, you know. That's what handled the scandal, you know. So I don't know. So when it comes down to that whole like lid stuff, I got personal family stuff, and my dad went in and out, you know. And then when it comes to my mom, like army dudes, she doesn't like army dudes. It's just that my dad had already crossed over into the regular world, and he was living like a regular guy. And then he found, then you know, when they knew each other, they found it was army dude. But you know, she's really into different types of dudes. You know, she's like a model type lady, because she was a model and everything back home. It's just when she came to America, she stopped living and shit. But anyway, so that's that. And I don't know, my thing is like now, like that I'm like this, like I want to have people in my life. So it's like, you know, how do we get people out of the bullshit, you know, so they could have lives and stuff? Because you know, a lot of the girls my age have kids, and I mean, I'm not saying it is a sentence depending on the circumstances, but you know, it's a fair advantage. Like, I'd like to get off the ground. I'd like to get stable. I'd like to be myself. So I gotta let other people get off the ground and be stable, you know. Because you know, what's the point of getting somebody out of necessity or need when you know you could let them be a better person and have a better relationship tomorrow? But anyways, it's your boy Sydney and Banana Republic pants. Wow, here comes the Fiasco Skate Shop. You look fucking awesome. Later.